It's Journal 2, and we've just really got into this semester and started doing our clinical rotations, and we started homework and started meeting for clinical with our class. And after, going through the syllabus with every professor in every class and getting some homework and getting some reading, I honestly think that I'm gonna be most interested in and most excited about modalities because of the fact that it's really hands-on, like we learn about it in class, so we have lab on Wednesday. We have to actually get to practice. We get to learn how to like different situations. We will do this type of modality. This week we've got into managing pain, like the steps of returning to play. How cells rebuild, just the process of that your muscles, ligaments, and all that go through to get back to where they need to be. Well, back to where they have to be able to play again, for the athlete to return to play. And that comes with a lot of responsibility on the athletic trainer because we talked about how if they re-injure or a scar gets infected or another problem happens, it's basically they blame you as an athletic trainer, which is kind of annoying. So you have to kind of know what you're doing when you're going through rehab with an injured athlete. But I really do think that I'll be most interested in that, and I'm really excited to learn how to do stim and ultrasound and all that, watching the upperclassmen and our certifieds do all the different modes. And you can do heat on ultrasound as well, like getting into all of that and why you would choose one mode or the other, why you would choose heat, no heat on ultrasound, the difference of stim with ice and stim with heat, the benefits of everything really is exciting, even if modalities basically go into anything that helps, like a psychological change in you to make the athlete or patient think that they're getting better. I think it'll help me become a better clinical or a better athletic trainer because that's what I want to be. Because I can help the athletes manage pain, break up scar tissue, help them come back from injuries at the right rate. I just really think that I'll be most excited about this one because there's so many different things to get into this semester with modalities. There's so many different sections between hydrotherapy and chirotherapy and laser and or light therapy and ultrasound and stim and everything like that. And just getting into what certified athletic trainer prefers what for this injury and why, and also why certifieds don't use one, use a couple because of their opinions. I'd love to hear that. I would like to understand their reasoning for using one over another. I'm also really excited to get into anatomy and kinesiology because learning all of the muscles and the bones and everything like that is really going to help me do, like, be able to perform the modalities, because then I'll know what's hurting and it'll be better with evaluation, injury evaluations, doing SOAP notes and everything like that. So the most excited I'll be for, I'll be the most excited for modalities, but anatomy and kinesiology is definitely a close second. So I'm really excited to get into, we are in the groove now, kind of, but once everyone kind of gets past the first couple weeks of school is when we're really going to get into stuff, and we're going to do quizzes, and lab is going to be real and hands-on, not just a short lab, like, because it's the beginning of the semester and we haven't learned anything. Lab's going to be real, it's going to be a full lab, and we're going to be hands-on in the King Center Clinic, or we could be in the Brooks Field House doing things. I'm just really excited to learn about how to help, because every time I'm in the clinic, someone is always using a modality on an athlete, and that could be me once I learn, and that'll be really exciting because then I'll finally be educated on all of that. So, yeah, school's going good so far. So is clinical. We're going to rotate on Monday, so that's exciting. But, yeah, it's been a good time so far. We'll see how it goes, I guess.